Common mistake number one. In the ayah, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, people tend to read it as Bismillahir Rahmanur Rahim, which is a mistake. There is a kasra under the noon, and the right way to read it, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, and not Bismillahir Rahmanur Rahim. Mistake number two. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. In that ayah, people tend to read it at times as Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, as in they go on to put a sukoon on top of the dal in Alhamd, whilst there's no sukoon there. It's actually a dhamma, where you make the do sound. So the right way to read it, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. The wrong way that some people tend to read it, Alhamd لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, which needs to be corrected. Mistake number three now. مَالِكِ يَوْمِ الدِّينَ. Some people tend to read it again with a sukoon. مَالِكْ يَوْمِ الدِّينَ. You know, so much to the extent that at times even they are not able to notice it. مَالِكْ يَوْمِ الدِّينَ. Almost sounds as if they're reading it the right way. But then if you observe carefully and very, in a vigilant way, you will observe that they're making a subtle sukoon, where they would read Malik Yawmiddin. So the right way to read it, Maliki Yawmiddin. And some people also tend to drag the word Maliki unnecessarily, where they would say Maliki Yawmiddin, which is also not right. The right way to read it, Maliki Yawmiddin. Mistake number four. And now, this is an important ayah, and we tend to notice a lot of people making this mistake. The ayah that needs to be read as Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka, you know the word Iyyaka, there's a shadda, so there's this layer of emphasis, Iyyaka, Iyyaka, but people tend to read it very loosely. They read it as Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in, which entirely distorts the meaning. It changes the meaning from the right meaning, which is Ya Allah, you alone we worship and you alone we seek help. It changes it from that to O sunlight, we worship you. O sunlight, we seek help from you. So this is something very serious, and we need to work on correcting this mistake for those who are making this mistake. Moving on to common mistake number five. If you take the ayah, Ihdina siratal, people tend to make a mistake where they read it as Ihdina saratal. So saratal, that's wrong. The right way to read it is with a kasra over the letter sad. Ihdina siratal. And then the ra too, some people tend to read it as Ihdina sirah, sirah, flat mouth, whilst it needs to be read round mouth. Ihdina siratal, ihdina siratal. Common mistake number six in the ayah, Alladhina, people tend to read it with a Z sound. Alladhina, Z, whilst the right way to read it, because the letter there is the letter Dhal, you need to read it Alladhina, Alladhina. And another mistake that people tend to make is with the word Alladhina and An'amta. They tend to join the two words unnecessarily when reading, and they read it like reading one word. Alladhina an'amta, Alladhina an'amta. The right way to read it, Alladhina an'amta. So basically, Alladhina an'amta alayhim, Alladhina an'amta. First Hamza and then Ayn. The next mistake, the next common mistake that people tend to make is with the word Al-Maghdubi. So, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ. They tend to confuse the letter غَيْن with the letter عَيْن. So they tend to read it غَيْرِ الْمَعْضُوبِ, which is wrong. The right way to read it, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ. And then the word ضُوبِ, people tend to, in the word Al-Maghdubi, the part ضُوبِ, they tend to read it as لُوبِ at times, or Dubi with a dal or a lam, whilst the right way to read it is with the letter dad. So ghayril maghdubi alayhim. And the last mistake towards the end of the surah that people tend to make is with the word walad. So there at times it is read as walad with a dal, or walat with a ta. The right way to read it, because it's a dad, walad-dallin. So ghayril maghdubi alayhim walad-dallin. So as you can see, there are common mistakes that we tend to make when reading Surah Al-Fatiha. And given that Surah Al-Fatiha is an integral, it is upon us, it's a work in progress, and it is upon us to improve our recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha. It is important for us to teach our children the right way to read the Noble Quran, to read Surah Al-Fatiha. So why don't you come and join our Quran program? We have teachers who teach across the week and even during the weekend. Classes can be structured, can be tailor-made according to your needs, insha'Allah ta'ala. So do get in touch with us and come and join our Quran program to improve your recitation of the Noble Quran, of the words of your Maker, to improve the recitation of Surah Al-Fatiha. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ease this journey upon us, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our efforts in this regard. And